Hey everybody, welcome back to Beyond the Beat. My name is Dave McKenzie, and this is another Metric Monday. Today what we're going to do is we're going to take a little shallow dive into a drum beat that any old drummer could play, like a basic drum groove while you program your beats. So we're going to do it in Luna. Hit the subscribe button if you like these videos, hit the like button, leave your comments below, and stay cool. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to program a little beat for you. So we're going to go up here, I just hit the plus sign. We're going to open up an instrument track. And we can basically just do it with like a simple instrument track. There's really not a lot to it. Basically, you just have to open up like what they mean by instrument is software instrument, right? So what comes up automatically is shape. So if I open up shape, we have all of these samples. Let's just use that. Here's the tempo. I'm gonna bring this down to like 90. I don't even know why. I'm just going to do that. And I'm going to expand. I'm just going to open up this window a little bit more so we can see it. There's different ways to do that. I just did it with my mouse by grabbing. If you go down here, as soon as you sort of hit the line that separates the two tracks, down up arrow comes up. And then I can just sort of click, like I can grab it with my mouse and stretch away to my heart's content. Now, the next thing that we're going to do in order to create this drum beat is we're going to take a look at the grid. The grid now is set to quarter notes. The grid is up here. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Those are measures. For those of you that don't read or write music, everything is written in measures that are sort of a finite amount of time. And the subdivisions are important. So we're going to put 16th notes up. Actually, you know what? Let's just do 8th notes. Okay, so that means that every beat that there is, 1, 2, 3, 4, is divided into, there's two. So there's 2 8th notes for every 1 quarter note. So basically it means that we've got 8 beats to play with. So now on my keyboard, that may sound confusing, but I'll just bear with me here. I can use R or T to expand. So let's make this a 2-measure beat. I'm gonna double click on one of these empty squares and it's not gonna do anything. There we go. So that's our kick drum, right? And then, so you can see here, so for it goes from 1, and then there's like we could have 8 kick drums here across the whole measure. Okay, this is 1 measure, and then if I highlighted this and looped it, it would sound like this. And the way that's counted is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So it just adds up to 8. Now we don't want that many kick drums in this beat. I'm gonna increase the volume later in a little bit, but so let's take some of them out. I'm gonna delete that one. So if you think about what a drummer does, right? They keep time with the kick drum, the snare drum, and the hi-hat. So here's a kick sample, right? And then here is a snare drum sample. That's a rim, that's a side stick. There's a snare drum. Layered on that, you can hear a clap. It's like a lo-fi sort of clap sound from the 808. So, you know, but it sounds like a nice EQ'd snare drum. So that's on beat 2. So beat 1 is the kick. Beat 2 is the snare. And we'll just put a kick drum on beat 3. And on beat 4, we'll put a snare drum. So now we've got a basic pattern where on beat 1, it's a kick. On beat 2, it's a snare. On beat 3, it's a kick. On beat 4, it's a snare. That's something that a drummer could do, right? Like that would be when we start kids out drumming here at Beyond the Beat, we would teach them a beat very similar to this and have them play it. Snare, kick, snare. You could build a whole song around that. Many songs have been built around that. You know, it's a beautiful, simple groove. And you could start just with that. And one of the cool things about it is you don't even need to put in a hi-hat. But for a drummer, they tend to play hi-hat to keep time. And it is just aesthetically really nice to hear that. So we're going to put in hi-hats on the 8th notes, okay? So we're going to put in hi-hats all along. So there's going to be 8 hi-hats. But still... on beats 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's beat 1 is kick, beat two is snare, beat three is kick, beat four is snare. Now, this is going to sound a little rigid when we play it back. But it's pretty good though, right? Like it's cool. Like it, we kind of know that it's not, you know, and then within this, you know, I would usually not put all these parts in one software instrument. I would sort of just have my kick drums here or whatever. But so I'm going to bring this down a little bit. Actually, I just want the hi-hats. Why is it not doing that? So I'm looping them, or I'm grabbing them all. There we go. So I just want my hi-hats down a little bit so that they're not too loud. All right, that's pretty cool. Now, one thing that you can do is you can vary... I'm going to open this up a little bit more. You can vary the volume of your hi-hats, right? And your kick and snares for that matter. Like, we may want to just actually loop all of our kicks and snares and just bring them up so that they're just maxed out, just to get that full punch. Right, sounds pretty good. And then for the hi-hats, maybe have the first one sort of loud, and then maybe the second one could be a bit quieter. And you can see them fade out a little bit here. And then the third one we could have sort of loud. So we start to create a bit of a pattern. Bring this one down a little bit so that, and then on all of the actual beats, we can have the hi-hat up a bit and then sort of ghost on these eighth notes a little bit, the second hi-hat. And then on this third one, we'll sort of bring it up. And then on this last one, we'll bring it down. So now we've got something that sounds a little bit more. It's got a bit more feel to it. Now we can open up our quantize grid by just hitting Q here. And I'll also note that I hit these sliders here to bring up the dynamics, all right? So the dynamics are how... It's a velocity, actually. They're calling it velocity. That's how loud the sample is played, all right? So I can close that now. And now I've hit the Q, and now our quantize section is set up here. So we can quantize things. We'll just call it eighth notes, and we can even swing it a little bit, right? We'll just sort of add a little bit of swing to it just so that it's a little bit groovy. Nah, I'm going to keep it straight. And here, the cool thing about MIDI stuff here, or like software instruments, is we have the choice. We could actually, you know, we could bring this up to 120 beats per minute and it would still work, right? That feels a little flustered. A little flussed. All right, here's 110. Let's bring it down to 105. 105. I'm going to go 100. So you can tell that those are samples, but that's something that a drummer would play, right? And then, you know, like often to make your beat a little bit more interesting, so I'm going to duplicate this. I'm going to hit, so while this is highlighted, right, I'm going to hit Command or Apple and D for duplicate. Now we've got two measures of exactly the same thing, right? So what we can do, we could actually... If we wanted to sort of imply something a little bit more interesting, you know, like we could do something simple, like we could put a second kick here and then maybe like open the velocity sliders again and bring this kick down a bit and just listen to that. That doesn't do much for me, so I'm going to get rid of it. What you could do if we wanted to give it a little bit more, you know, of a... funky feel, what we could do is we could imply, so I'm going to go up here to my grid, and now we set the grid to eighth notes, so everything is just, you know, very easy to block in as eighth notes. But if we move it to 16ths, I can put a little ghost kick here. What I mean by ghost is we're going to really barely hear it, but it's going to imply the sixth note, the 16th note feel, and we're going to hear a little groovy kick going, pushing into beat measure two, right? Right, and then we could even add that. So now we've got something that's kind of a little bit cooler, you know. Let's listen to it. Or we could even go eighth notes, right? Like, to bring sort of on beat three there, we'll have two kick drums, right? Right, and then that's just a cool sort of sounding beat. We don't even need to have this extra eighth note here on beat three. So let's try something else here. Let's go. We're sort of stuck in a loop here. Undo. Apple Z, everyone's best friend. We could even go one and snare kick, right? That's kind of cool. We could make this kick loud a bit. So let's listen to that. Two, three, four, one, two, three, and four, and one. Or actually, we could actually have the kick sort of land right here after that last snare. Right? And now we've got like a simple two-measure beat to sort of work with. If you're just doing a demo or something, that may be enough for your song, right? It's really cool, and you could like layer something real on it, like you could have a shaker. I'm a big fan of layering like real sounds with sampled sounds, so you can layer a clap, right? Like a real clap. I'm just putting a real clap right over a kick or right over the snare sound, which is not, it's not groundbreaking or anything, but it's going to sound a little bit more unique from your studio, whatever mic you're using, whatever preamp you're using, whatever, you know, just like the size of your hands and how you sort of hear a clap and want to do it. It's just, it's endless how much fun it is to sort of make beats and to make music with it. Now you could go on to program other things like synthesizers in here, or you could just use real instruments. We'll take this further, but that's just a basic beat. Like just like a, like it's not totally simple because we've got some 16th notes in there, but it's a beat that a drummer would play. Of course there's fills and there's all kinds of things and build ups that we can do, but I wanted to give you like a two measure figure that you could sort of work with. So try to recreate this in your own DAW, DAW meaning a digital audio workstation, and let me know how it goes, guys. Hey everybody, I hope you guys really liked that video. We love making them for you, so definitely subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, leave your comments below. We're in it to make music for you and to help you make your own music, all right? So stay creative, stay cool, peace.